Hello everyone, it's Annette here. Welcome to my new process video. I'm so happy that you joined. I'm creating a dreamy, whimsical layout today using the Pinkfresh Studio Days of Splendor collection. We have a new family member, a little boy, Zalan. He is the first son of my niece. I took some cardstock in coordinating colors, dark blue, light blue, and these warm, smooth pink lilac shades. They all coordinate really well with the Like a Dream pattern paper, which is the base of my layout. I did not use any cut file this time, I just went ahead and doodled some myself. Well, not only some, I doodled a lot of flowers, small ones and bigger ones, and I just simply fussy cut them. I needed lots and lots of clouds, and at the end it went so well that I didn't even have to draw first, I just went ahead and fussy cut that without any drawing lines. I am arranging the clouds on my base. I want to create several layers using foam to raise the clouds. I did three layers of them. There are some I adhered right on the background. The others I raised with one layer foam. And there is a third layer above all the others with two layers of foam. The first layer is the dark blue clouds. Then comes the darker rose and finally the light blue and the light rose shades. Yes, this layout got a little bit thicker and really three-dimensional, but I want to put it in a nice frame and put it on the wall. It will be a nice gift for my niece. At this time, I wasn't so sure about what photo I'm gonna use. First, I wanted to use this lovely photo of my little son, but then my niece posted this wonderful cute photo of Zalan, so I knew right away that this will be the one for this layout. I printed the photo in a form of a cloud itself, so it fits between the other clouds. And of course I used the black and white version because the layout is really colorful and this picture is so cute and I think it fits the best when it's black and white. Now I am speeding up my process a little bit because it took really a long time to arrange all the clouds. I let the clouds run off my page and I cut down the excess, which I was able to use on another part of the layout. So at the end, I had some leftover clouds, but I'm sure I will use the ones on another layout sooner or later. I arranged the clouds mostly on the borders, and I wanted to leave a little space in the middle of the layout to see the lovely pattern of the background and to have a quiet part on the layout. I am in love with the textile bows. I think there is no layout I didn't use one or two of them. I also love these small alpha stickers. Here I use them to write the name of baby Zalan. I also embellished the layout with some flower ephemera. I think this cheers up the dark colors a bit. And of course, I find a nice place for the shooting star ephemera. And that dragonfly, I just love it. I think I could use 20 of them. Off camera, I took a metallic gel pen and doodled on the background. I colored some of the stars and I also used some sparkling jewels to decorate the stars and add more sparkle to the background. And this is my final layout. You can see some detail shots and some close-ups. You can find all your supplies under the video. Thank you so much for watching and don't forget to like, subscribe and comment. I love to read any of your comments or questions that you might have. See you soon. Bye.